All right, welcome back to Midfall Speedball. And up next, we have The Matrix Path of Neo with Ari V. All right, take it away.
All right. Actually, hang on a second. I forgot to start my timer. Oh, well, I don't care. Just start when the code falls. Right off the bat, there's going to be a frame skip that's easy on PC, but a little bit difficult on console. Morpheus is going to offer us the pill, and we can skip it at a certain frame.
You take the blue pill, the story ends. You wake up in your bed and believe
got it.
Whatever you
want. Oh my god, I got it. That saves at least 20 seconds.
You stay in one.
Very easy on PC, but the frames are a little bit more stagnant or less stagnant on console. So he's going to keep talking, but we're going to go into the dream. They give you a choice between red and blue pill. If you take the blue pill, of course, it sends a cutscene, you wake up in your bed, and you basically fail. However, now we're going to be dreaming. And they just thwart you into the middle of the game, and just don't tell you how to do anything, really, and hope for the best. And this is their way of determining what kind of skill you have. But since we're dirty, filthy cheaters, we already know the controls. And the farther you get in a simulation, the harder the difficulty you can obtain. It's not what I wanted to do. We're going to lose a little time with that. It's going to tell us what guns do. I'm going to use focus for better accuracy, because guns reduce normal civilian enemies by quite a bit. Up until this point, if you fail or die, you have to redo the dream. However, if you die here, you can continue. So we're going to try to take as much gunfire as possible. And this could be really fast or really slow. This is going to be slower because the outlier in this situation took cover. Alright, and we're dead. It's going to give us a difficulty selection. I'm going to go easy, and I already skipped it. And now, just like any other great night, you're going to have an awesome dream, and you're going to wake up, and you're going to be at work.
Remember.
Oops. Pressed the wrong button. One difference between PC and console versions, especially PS2 versions, is that I can remove my memory card and skip certain sequences. In that case, it's the talent web, and I could just speed right through it. Otherwise, the game has to autosave. And since I'm already on a completed file to skip cutscenes, I don't have to worry about saving anything ever.
Go now.
You don't actually have to link up, you just need to not be seen by police officers or agents.
Wait. Hide behind that filing cabinet.
And there is no way to go around this or anything. Cycles are the same, but there's no way to not be seen, unfortunately. You don't have to wait for his cue.
Into the empty cubicle. Good. Wait.
As soon as you get into the next area, designated area, Morpheus skips ahead. So, don't have to worry about any kind of desync issues. All this is cycle-based instead of voice-based. You don't actually have to do this here. The problem is, if you screw this up, it's going to cost a lot of time. You don't actually have to dive across and stuff. You can actually do it blindly if you feel like you're an amazing player, which I am not.
Move slowly to the corner.
So right here we can link up, but you don't have to, technically.
Any luck?
Nothing. This Anderson guy's either slick or stupid. Probably lock himself in a room somewhere.
So yeah, while we're waiting on through all this text and everything, there are three different versions of this game, and they all have three weird differences. The first off being, If you play the Xbox version, you'll notice that the text at the bottom of the screen is white here. On Xbox, it's yellow.
There is an open filing cabinet behind her desk. Hide there.
Also, all three versions have a different loading screen. This loading screen is plain code. PC version is lit code, like glowing. Xbox version is glowing with a loading symbol. Or loading text, rather.
Anderson? No, I haven't. If I do, I'll be sure to let you know.
There is an office at the end of the next hall.
Alright, there's a trick here.
Outside. Get there.
If you link up, you'll get seen. If you do it too soon, because that officer always looks to the right,
outside.
And you'll get caught through the wall. It's a great feature.
Metacortex, how may I direct your call? One moment, please. Agent Brown on line 2.
Ah, damn agents. Hold my calls, I'll be back in a few.
Go, now.
He's over here!
I'm gonna use a human shield here. There we go. If you always go that way, usually the officer tries to grab you and you have to shove him back. If you go there and kind of use that guy as a human shield, he never grabs. Nice time save.
Leave with the agents or leave with Morpheus? Why is this happening to me?
So right here you can accept capture and skip that level in the next level. And now we're gonna go immediately up into the Nebuchadnezzar into training. Because as you know in the movie, he gets on the scaffolding and immediately pussies out. So you can do the same in a speedrun. Usually they give you through the scaffolding, the construction, then you go back in and...
It's not real. Just pretend you
have to fail. Kind of. However, there is an option to escape and go with Trinity, which is required for 100% speedruns.
You are a natural.
You can actually escape and go with Trinity, but it doesn't change much except for 100% accolades.
Take too much damage.
It is very, very difficult to do that, by the way.
Keep practicing silent takedowns for now.
And you can actually get a gun, which most people thought was a myth, but you can actually get an officer's gun in that level, which is pretty cool. We're actually just going to kill him for safety. This one leading against the wall, you can actually go around and do some dodge motions. But depending on how aggressive his AI is, you actually can lose a little bit of time on that.
A strike combo. Now would be a good time to drive through the enemy strikes with your own. One more thing.
Yeah, the first part as a kid, crack open the I was like to find 12 or 13.
Crates. How original.
That first part is a little bit difficult. Where's my other guy? There he is. Double takedowns like this are very fast because they're always a one hit. Especially on minor enemies or apprentices. I'm gonna wait to kind of funnel him in again. We're gonna do this a lot through this tutorial section.
Oh, let's cause some real pain.
Now we're gonna have red shirts with slightly higher HP. Can you stop? Oh boy. These guys have insanely low HP, so it's not a big deal.
Let's try some judo.
Oh, really? This is very strange. Yeah, see, just very slightly higher HP. So the backstory behind this, after the joke.
So, what's with the outfit?
Oh, that? I don't know. I think it fits the scene. You don't like it?
So the backstory behind this is, I had the Xbox version growing up, and it was stuck in the disk drive because Xbox was notorious for having broken disk drives. It was stuck in there for 6 months, so I had nothing to play but this. So, that's the reason why I know dumb stuff about this, for the most part. Alright, so you're usually supposed to sneak around here, but I'm gonna bait this guy.
Stun you, they'll go for a throw, so watch your back.
And I didn't get to bait him. Because of lag. Anyway, you can strike that guy and funnel the other guy in there, and then do a double grab like I was doing earlier.
Weapon placed.
And it saves some time with having to fight people.
We're really starting to get the hang of this.
However, I failed it, but I didn't really fail it because the buzzer didn't go off. Because if the buzzer alarm goes off, then you're kind of screwed, because then you have to defeat every enemy to unlock the next door. Don't worry, they don't hear that. Uh-oh, this is bad. Yeah, that's bad. That's okay, it happens. Now there's gonna be a couple waves of enemies, but it's fine. It's happened before.
Final test is loaded.
Okay,
you'll
we got it.
Up one floor level. Use the ladder to get there.
Ow, wait a minute. What am I thinking? So from this point on, we actually get our jump strike, which is great for movement, so I'm going to be spamming that a lot. For some reason, they don't give you it until this point.
Jump's weapon's just up ahead. Enjoy.
I'm going to save that weapon for later.
Ready for the big finale?
What have you got in mind?
And now this is their so-called tournament, which is doing exactly what you've just done. The only difference is now you have environmental damage and environmental kills. So nothing really changes. Now we're going to be doing a couple waves of this while it tells us about focus, which is basically slowing down time. Which is a borrowed characteristic from Enter the Matrix, which was the predecessor to this game. Regardless of what you do, you always start in the same spot. Even if you try to be perfectly centered, the game's still gonna recenter you in the area. Which kinda sucks, but it's alright. Ideally, I want to take out both reds if I have two reds, because a red won't fall to a normal attack. And so it takes up maybe an extra second or two. This time we have all three reds. So I'm just going to do a step-up sidekick. Remember that weapon? Now we're gonna use it. Because this guy's kind of annoying. Where is he? There he is. A jumping strike with a weapon like I just did there is a very broken characteristic and feature. When we do sword fighting, it's going to be insanely powerful on the easy difficulty. Very powerful. And we're going to go talent level real quick, I believe. No, we're not. Okay. No, we're not. Actually, yep, we are. And I can instantly skip it without auto-saving, like I mentioned, because I removed my memory card. Here comes one of the more hated sections of the game.
I knew you would come. Your blade skills are legendary. Today, you will learn that mine are as well.
Hmm. Okay, come on, Neo. Work with me here. Really? He's just being a little... Oh my god. There we go. He's never that resilient, honestly. Especially for the first phase. Usually doesn't get too irritating until Trinity shows up, because she's usually more of a burden than she is of a help. And there is Trinity. Got him. Okay. I tried to salvage that, and I almost didn't make it.
This creep isn't going down easy.
Because sometimes I'll focus on Trinity, then I have
Dodge
to
attacks,
switch up my tactics ever so slightly.
Oh.
Excellent.
Okay, now he's going to use duplicates. However, every time he uses duplicates, his real one is the same every time, which is always going to be the last guy. And you don't have to worry about hitting any of his clones or false people. I don't know what you call those. He's right over here. Please stop stunning me. He's gonna do this several times. However, if you just wait to look at the last one, this is very simple. Just don't lose track of which one he is. Oh my god. Can I stop getting stunned? Where'd he go? Okay, there he is. And he'll do this weird thing where you have to wait for the game to recognize that the encounter is over, like this little flash thing, because this is the end of it. Oops. Mashed too many times. And we're still going to be doing training for upwards of about 38-ish minutes. Pretty much. And now, finally, for one of the cooler parts of the game. Oh, I missed the dialogue skip. If you focus and jump before that, you can actually skip that little dialogue. This one, it wants you to do a wall run, which is one of the most useless features in the game. However, you don't actually have to do a wall run, you could just do a focus jump. My frame rate is very bad on console here, which is fine. With apprentice level style enemies like this, we're still going to do this and then just ignore using our sword because they go down very easily. Melee weapons have a certain health charge to them, so that's why I'm picking up charges, if that makes any sense. Because even swords like this will break. And now we're fighting. I'm actually going to fight the ghost. See if I could... Yeah, I got the skip. Nice. There's certain sequences called code flexing that where Neo will flex in code form, and then you learn a new ability. I'm not sure how many frames it is to skip it, but it can be skipped if you're mashing hard enough. Ooh, this song hurt. Okay. Okay, that was a very slow fight, but now we get to hear from Link.
Barely. What's going on?
Much to the disappointment of most people, Tank is not your operator in this game. It is, in fact, Link. May not be able to pull you out in time. Here's another code flex. And we skipped it. Nice.
Yo, watch out. This place is starting to fall apart.
I got stunned by the rubble. That sucks. It's not enough just to get to the end here. You actually have to defeat all the enemies. And fire does hurt. Now I can go over the fire and fight everybody else. And now I'm actually going to use the sword because there's a lot of people here. So I'm just going to mash triangle or Y, however you want to call it. And that fire pretty much killed everybody, which was nice.
Sorry about that, Neo.
Occasionally you'll get a lurker from behind the fire where it was originally, and that's kind of annoying because you have to go back and get him. It's not enough just to reach the door, unfortunately. And we're still going to do jump strike movement, because we're going to have to traverse quite a ways around here. And we want to use sword here, because these guys have much more HP. How did he dodge my jump strike? What a cheater. These apprentices, however, right here, have very reduced health. They're the same guys from inside. Still bearing in mind that we have charges on the sword, so I'm trying to make sure I pick up any remnants that I can. Oh, he almost got me there. Why won't you die? Okay, he's dead. Now we get to wait for a cutscene. And the sick beat.
My friend, you are a natural.
Now we're gonna go to the fireplace. And this fire really hurts when it blows up. Because for some reason, when a sword touches fire, explosions happen. I'm not sure if that's just anime or some kind of actual chemical compound in Japanese steel. Really? Okay, that's actually good. He took me away from the fire. Now I'm not near as scared. And we're gonna have a couple more apprentices come over here in about a second. Still very low damage, very low health. Okay. These guys just have a lot of health, which is kind of irritating. I lost my charges on my sword. There we go. And there the little dudes. That took much longer than it should have, unfortunately. I want to make sure my sword's drawn for this, because now we're going to go into the boss fight stage of this. Which, if you remember, what I've been keeping telling you is that jump striking with a sword is very powerful. And you're going to see how powerful it is right here. I just saved myself there. I was going to get stunned, but we're good now. Instead of just jump striking, I can actually just counter into the, like, just like that. These guys are very annoying because they can tunnel under the ground and then pop up somewhere else. They're basically like the, Diglets. I had to think of the name. And we gotta wait for the end of this here. That was not a very good winter training.
Excellent.
And we don't actually have any skill points to spend for a little bit here. So we're just going to be mashing through that or skipping through it. And now we're going to do aerial training, I believe. Yep.
Rules of this.
And now the Matrix has changed their clothes again. Now we're just going to do the same thing with these guys. What in the world is going on today? It must know it's a marathon run. Thing is here, I can't actually lose time. Because this is basically an auto. My game is bugged. Let's try this. It's acting like the Burly Brawl for some reason. I just need to score a certain amount of points to fulfill my objective. The problem is, even when I fulfill my objective, I still have to stay in the level. And every time I defeat a wave or hit somebody, I get points. And, yeah. I'm supposedly trying to beat Morpheus's high score in the simulation right now.
You made it to round 4. Here, see if you can put this staff to good use.
We're not actually going to use the staff. Nope. We're going to try to achieve this high score without defeating the wave. Because every time we defeat a wave, the timer actually pauses until Link stops talking, and then he introduces the next wave.
Incredible. One more wave and you're gonna break Morpheus's record.
As soon as we get to 5,000, we don't have to do much anymore. Okay, we've reached 5,000. So we're gonna get creative here. Ow! Basically, what we're wanting to do is to not complete another wave, so we just have to wait out this timer. So if you have any donations, this would be a prime time. This is one of 3 waits in the game. That's like 3 minutes or more. He's gonna try but inevitably fail to hit us or kill us. And we have another wait coming up. Oh, I'm sorry.
Odd, you're all good.
Okay.
We don't have any donations right now, but I will just remind people that we have a bunch of incentives coming up. So, for example, the car body and car color for Road Trip Adventure. I believe the duck is still winning for the body. Let me confirm. The duck is the best one, of course, by far. Yep. The duck body is currently in the lead for that, so you are really against duck cars, which I don't know why you would. You could donate for that. There's also, see, we've got a few character bid wars for Mario Kart 8 and Crash Team Racing. So if you prefer one of the characters in that game, you can donate to that.
Can we donate for Dingo Dial? Because he's the greatest character ever. I love him.
Dingo is pretty goofy. He's a goofy guy. Yeah. But yeah, a lot of good stuff to donate for. So yeah, we're going to take it away, Valerie.
Okay. While we have a little bit of time, like I mentioned, there are three different versions. PC has the fastest loads. However, coming up in Reloaded, which will be the second movie in this sequence, the first major version difference is going to rear its ugly head. In my case, a beautiful head, because I hate escort missions so much. And if you played this game, you will remember Captain Roland. And nobody liked Captain Roland, because he's a big old bitch.
Time's up!
And as soon as he says time's up, we're going to mash as fast as possible, because there's this really cool anime-style cinematic exit, which I don't care about. I'm going to skip another talent web. The only thing that's really skewed from this playthrough versus a new file playthrough is skill point allocation might be slightly different. Okay, now we're going to learn how to shoot. As a young child, I skipped this level quite a bit, but now as an aging boomer, I like to play this level quite a bit.
I'm taking away your ability to fight hand to hand.
Guns are very powerful in this game.
Remember to focus, Neo. Your shots become more accurate. Watch out, Neo. The boss is on to you.
Can I skip? It's starting to turn around. There we go. Okay, so that was a little bit messy. However, one of the big differences is I don't have free aim in this game. I can either toggle my weapon, or I can choose to hold it when switching targets with my right stick. However, PC has free aim, which gives them a huge advantage in the level called Deja Vu. However, I really like the ability to lock on like this and switch targets with my right analog stick. There's a lot of chicken playing with the so-called boss here, because I need him to move and not stop moving. And you can actually die during these cutscenes here if you get wedged in the wrong spot, which is very unfun.
Try more aerial targeting. Use wall runs and jumps to catch big air, target an enemy, then fire away. Not only does it make you hard to hit, but it looks cool.
And because they took my ability away to do kung fu, I can't actually do my method of movement. So if I try to do it right now, I can only jump. Which is okay, I guess. It gives me a break from doing the same movement tech for 2 hours. They really want you to hit the fire extinguisher here. There are various pots here and upgrades that will fill your health, or there are certain weapon stashes.
That's the guy you want to go after. He's your ticket out of this simulation.
Which one of them near the end I really want to get, because it's going to refill my submachine gun ammo. And submachine guns cut through this boss really well. For a second, I didn't think he was dead.
Boss is getting away. Hurry, Neo!
So there's going to be a weapon stash around here. There's supposed to be an Easter egg, but it's a well-known feature that the weapons are there. And I need it.
Hey, you found my secret stash. Nice job, detective.
And I'm very low on ammo, so this is not going to be a pretty fight. There we go.
The youngin, drop it off!
You technically get unlimited ammo for this, but the problem is you have to reload into the ammo, which I don't like to do. I want this guy. There you are. And now we get to fight the boss. And because this is easy, we're just gonna go bloop 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 right in his face. And that's weapon training. And now we know Kung Fu. Get out of my way. So this is one of the weirder quirks when they designed this game. Oh, hang on. So, when you pick up a staff like this during this fight, usually, in a normal situation, if you don't pick up the staff and you pick up one of the wooden swords instead, Morpheus will also grab a weapon. But if you pick it up from this specific spot, for some reason Morpheus doesn't grab it. Oh, he got me. And so you basically can just cheat through this entire fight, and it's kind of silly. Oh, he is destroying me. Why PS2 over PC? I'll get to that in the second movie. I gotta wait for my focus to charge back up. That's usually why I try to run away from him. PS2 version has certain skips in it that PC can't do, including talent web skips and escort skips. Please attack me. There we go. Current predictions show the PC would be faster. There is something. Just based on loading times alone. Right now my preferred version is PS2. I have yet to be able to test the Xbox version to see if it has similar changes or features. It's a very young game, and I'm hoping that more people pick it up because of this.
Catch me if you can.
Because I want more people to see maybe if, like, if you play it on backwards compatibility with either 360 or PS3, how it will fare in terms of loading. We're gonna skip wall running here by doing a little bit of this. Oh, I didn't get my roll skip. Okay. I'm gonna skip wall running once again. I'm gonna try something here. Ah, I missed it. I brushed up against the wall. I didn't get it. Okay, we're gonna have to do this the normal way. If you fall off there, intentionally run off there, the game actually spawns you beyond this area, because the game doesn't think that you can fall off any of the walls out of bounds. So unfortunately, I'm gonna have to do this, but that's all right. Basically, you just skip all this and you spawn right up here. And we're still gonna beat Morpheus by my eye, because Morpheus is slow. I own both the PC and PS2 version. PC version is interesting just simply because of the free aspect, which is great for Deja Vu. Because Deja Vu is a nightmare without free aim. It's during a normal playthrough, Deja Vu is easy because you get closed off doors and everything. This is actually Deja Vu right here.
Neo.
I didn't skip my code flex here. Gonna watch a smooth cutscene here. We're not actually gonna kill anybody during this level.
You stop! What the hell?
We're gonna at least try not to, at least. And this level is very chaotic. Please don't blow this up. Thank you. And that tank has like the biggest hitbox ever. And it respawns during that cutscene. Alright, they blew up the other one. Don't blow up this one. Okay, thank you. There we go. That's the problem with not having frame, is I can get stuck on enemies like that there. So that's why we really, oh my god, my camera. Please! Alright, there we go. Whew. I might do sissy strats here. Nope, I'm not gonna do sissy strats.
They're trying to wall me in.
Open the door. There you go. And that guy just went flying for some reason. Don't blow that up, please. Thank you. Okay, blew up later. That's fine. Is there health in here? No, there's not. That's bad. Oh my. Okay, I have to kill these guys. Oh my god. Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god. The problem is they can actually come through the door here at any second, but I need to wait because I have to do sissy strats. This is on PC. It was originally released in 2005 for PC, Xbox, and PS2.
These walls, do they know where I am?
I want to wait on that grenade to blow up. Ow!
Hit him with a grenade!
Don't hit me with a shotgun, please. There we go.
Get ready. Here they come.
And now Apoc is going to come to our rescue.
Yo,
and now
I'm
the
here.
Scary parts are over.
Apoc.
Now we're actually going to kill people. There we go. Stop levitating, please. There we go. We're actually going to take the grenade launcher for reasons that, so I can skip this dialogue and open this door earlier. If you don't take the grenade launcher, it takes longer to open that door. Yes, certain glitches or tricks don't work on PC because I'm on a broken game file right now, which is going to allow me to do something really stupid. Actually, I'll take this. I don't want to see it. And now we're going to go into the drains.
Trinity, let's go!
We gotta move, they're right behind us. Neo, let's go! All the passageways are barred. We don't need this.
Yeah, the PC version is a little bit hard to come by. There are millions of Xbox copies on eBay and Amazon. It took me a long time to find my PC CD-ROM online, and I actually bought it for about $20, so that was a pretty good steal. So I'm just gonna run through the targeting here. Oh, you're still alive.
We're pinned down!
They're carrying demo packs. They must really want
there
us.
There we go. I forgot I had the grenade launcher. Usually that's an automatic pickup, if not. Because you can only have three weapons at a time. Why are you alive? Sir, excuse me. You can't be under certain areas when you blow stuff up, otherwise the game will kill you. So I had to be in a certain spot while I blew that up.
Good job. You really saved us back there.
Okay. You can actually blow up these pipes for some weird reason. Also, if I put a bomb here and blow it up, I can actually go through earlier, but the problem is their bomb that's invisible blows up as well. It's kind of funny. Hallway right there is a little bit annoying to use the guns in because not everyone's in a good line, and I already have a bomb, so I don't actually have to defeat any waves of enemies here. And now our wall's gonna be cut off.
No, no. Damn it, he did it again. Anyone got a jet pack?
I think I saw another jet pack back that way. I'll get it.
Neo, hang on, we'll get to you.
Stranger danger. Okay, I'm gonna do a very ancient technique here.
There's an agent in here. What do I do?
Now. Stop, please.
He can't hurt you if he's busy gotten bullets.
Okay. Oh, I almost got it. He is very aggressive. I actually can't get it. This is weird. This is the most marathon run ever. Usually you can actually... Okay, I was about to say. Usually you can actually stand behind the corner and just sit there and he won't know what to do. But that time I actually couldn't get it. That was very... Oh, oh god. Uh-oh. This one... if you die too early there, you have to redo the fight. Okay, good. I have to redo the fight. That's awesome. Oh well. That's a great time loss there. Okay. Anyway, let's see if I can actually get it this time. And this guy just eats the grenade like a champ. Anyway, that's my mistake, but that's fine. We're actually about 3 or 4 minutes ahead of my PB, so I'm okay.
What the hell? No, Neo! Damn it, he did it again. Anyone got a death pack?
Let's see if we can get it this time.
I think I saw another death pack back that way. I'll get it.
Neo, hang on. We'll get to you.
Wait, he's not going to last 10 seconds with that, is he?
Shut up, he'll make it.
There's an agent in here. What do I do?
Neo, there we go.
Stay away from him and keep shooting.
So if you just do it like this, he won't move at all. The AI doesn't know what to do. The game developers really like this take on giving you certain situations where you have to fail or that you can't actually succeed. This is one of those situations. The first one is actually in the office, and this is the second one, where you have to fail, and you have to accept your fate, which is that you can't beat this guy. Even if you throw him off, he has infinite health. You can keep killing him again and again, and nothing will change. And they're gonna use that in this game a lot, because that's what happened in the movies, in the series, is that you just can't escape what's your fate. And that's why Morpheus asked Neo, do you believe in fate? And Neo says no, and Morpheus asks, why not? And Neo's reply is, because I don't like the fact that I'm not in control of my life. And that's what the Matrix is all about, is controlling fates and controlling people's lives. Controlling certain outcomes. It has taken them a very long time to find this. Did I softlock my game? There it is.
Neo! We're setting the charge. Stay away from the wall.
Fire in the hole!
We've got to get that agent off Neo!
If we're waiting, I could mention that we've got some bid wars and goals coming up. Would that be good?
Good work.
Sure. Let's not die.
Yeah.
Okay, I didn't die. We're good.
Not dying. Awesome. That's what I like to see.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, let me just bring up these bid wars. Yep, so as mentioned earlier, we've got a lot of bid wars coming up. There is Save or Kill the Animals in Super Metroid Project Base. Currently, Save is currently in the lead. So
you'll
if you don't
want
like
to kill
the
those animals.
Yeah.
Save the frames.
Saving the frames or the animals. It's your choice. And then for Star Control Origins, you can name your captain, orders a flagship bid war. And a file name for The Legend of Zelda 2. Currently, the file name is Sauce. Which is pretty great.
Hmm.
So, any of those sound appealing to you, go and click exclamation mark donate, and it'll all go towards St. Jude's.
Okay. So now we're going to get to a non-reused part of the level, and I'm going to want to put my guns away. And I'm going to run on this and skip going down the other way. Okay, that was gonna fall. And I'm gonna do this once more again in the next room. Because I don't want to fight all these guys. They have families. And we're gonna go straight to the ladder. Boom. Pacifist Neo. Okay, now we actually have to we actually have to spend a point. And there we go. And now we have to go rescue Morpheus. But first, we need to remodel this lobby. Wow, his body went flying. He's still alive. Okay. And this is almost exactly like the dream that we started the game with. And for PC players, this was like the first introduction of like, okay, how in the world am I aiming this weapon? Because with console, it's a little bit easier because it's lock-on, but there's so much stuff going on here. If you happen to choose a harder difficulty, this is the first time where you just slam your desk in frustration. His bullets really hurt. I need to swap this out. There we go. I don't want to pick up the grenades by accident. And here come riot shields. One of the more fun things to deal with in this game. Very frustrating to get bonked by a riot shield. However, if you do a jump kick and an Alabama slam, it's perfectly easy. And they're dead.
We lose Morpheus if we don't spit this up.
Oh, we got one more alive. Yes, that is a pro wrestling reference, by the way.
Not much time. Let's blow the elevator.
That was a very good lobby. One of the things is when we're doing the movement tech with the jumping and kicking, if we upgrade our aerial attack, we actually lose that animation and we get a worse one. So that's why I want to make sure when I'm upgrading, I'm not upgrading willy-nilly, because most of the upgrades I don't really use. I just need to spend them because they force you to spend them. And then you go on and you go on your merry way. However, if you upgrade it, you can't go back unless you go level select. Because upgrades are retrospective.
We have to take out that agent.
Trinity!
There we go.
Nice shot.
Not so bad yourself.
And yes, the ragdoll physics are quite fun.
Got company.
I always like to try to get to the side of these guys right here, because if you miss, it's going to hit one of the other guys behind them. The problem is Trinity killed one of them, so that kind of messed up my my flow there, but that's okay. Oh, it's on the roof right here. Om nom nom nom. Guess what? We got riot shields. Alabama slam it. Boom. Once again. There we go. You have no choice but to use the bullet dodge to progress through that. I didn't pick up my grenade launcher, did I?
Shoot down the chopper!
Did I? I did not. That's bad. I'm gonna miss a cycle on this because of that. Okay, that sucks. I didn't get it down here. I went to the wrong spawn area for it. That's my fault.
The agent's back.
Trinity! I can't do this much longer!
One of the annoying parts when you're trying to bullet dodge like that is if you get into a fight stance, you'll actually do backflips backwards instead of doing a bullet dodge. That's a little bit frustrating. You can actually take down this chopper without the grenade launcher. It's just easier to do with it. I'm gonna try to get an angle here. There we go. Really, it missed? Alright. Oh, riot shields. Okay, I didn't get the Alabama Slam there, but that's fine.
Does this guy ever give up?
Where's Trinity? Okay.
Trin, shoot the agent.
I had to wait for her to not be stunned. Grenades actually hit one of the dudes dropping down, which is the problem. So now we're behind on cycles. So now we have to wait for the chopper, to come in again. I'm not sure what's up with my camera right now. There we go. Problem is we have to defeat this wave of agents, or soldiers rather, and potentially an agent. What you can do there, if you're really brave, is you can hold down your focus and then grapnel button and you could throw that guy off the building as soon as he lands. The problem is if you do the wrong combination, you'll do a dive with him and you'll die running off the building. It looks really cool, but it's not safe. There we go. Had to get rid of my weapon. So we're not at a good pace for this level specifically. But now we get to do the fun part. I'm just gonna run away from these dudes. Nice. That happens occasionally. Okay. Okay, we're gonna have to try this a slow way. The game has decided we need to do the ledge. You don't actually have to do the ledge here. It's just that the game thinks that we need to do it. And it ate my input. This is interesting. Dodges bullets, can't jump to a helicopter. Makes sense. There we go. What? Come on, game. I don't know what the game's problem is. It won't give me this. That has to get it. Okay. I don't know what in the world is happening. I've never seen that before. This is basically the auto-scroller, just hitting everybody and all that kind of fun stuff. Since it's on easy, we don't actually have to do too much. However, shattering this glass will kill my frame rate, like it does there. Oh my god, those drops.
Let's move.
And this gun does overheat, just like any other version. The spawns are the same every time. You don't take really any damage at all from soldiers in this difficulty. The one difficulty, you can get killed really easily here, especially from enemy helicopters. Yeah, I've never seen the double jump do that before. That was interesting. And I wasn't doing that on purpose. I actually just couldn't get it.
We have to move, Neo.
Sometimes that guy's alive down there. And this dude is randomly alive. Oh my god, my frames.
I'm taking her down. Hang on.
So, big difference in difficulty here. You don't actually have to take out this enemy chopper. Usually you slow down and use focus to do it. But you don't have to do it here. Same thing with the rockets. The giant bazookas they shoot at you, you don't actually have to take out. Harder difficulties you do. Which is what I want to do next, is actually do a difficulty known as the One. Because it changes things quite a bit. Like in Deja Vu, you wouldn't run through the crossfire like that, you'd actually have to do all the fights. There's the other chopper right there. It actually goes down without focus on easier fire. On easier difficulty, rather. Oh, I thought that was an agent for a second. Yeah, it's fine. It's just hard to do this run without making mistakes, so... And plus, this is just a really fun game to play. See, those missiles do, like, nothing.
Take him down, Neo.
And this chopper always crashes, so... You don't really have to try. I remember my original casual playthroughs, I was just sweating because of that helicopter.
Neo, watch your fire.
Is that the man? I thought I killed you! Die! Okay, thank you. See, it doesn't really do anything. So it's stupid to waste focus on blowing up those warheads. I'm sorry to report that whoever thought that they were the cutest person in chat is officially not the cutest person anymore because May is here.
Get up, get up.
Okay, and now we've rescued Morpheus. Do you believe it now, Trinity? Yeah, it sucks, but it's natural selection, you know? And now we get to fight Smith. And this is where things get,
You're doomed, Mr. Anderson.
I will explain what I'm doing. Maybe.
Where are you going, Mr. Anderson?
Maybe one of the hardest boss fights ever. If you don't screw around like I am. So what I'm doing is activating triggers, because certain fights like this have certain scripted moments from the movie. And I'm going to have to wait on a train cycle now, because as you know, if you played this, you can't beat Smith. He just keeps regenerating. I gotta stun him for a little bit and then go back. There we go. And I'm gonna try to use Mr. Thursday's strat here. If I can get the train to come. I gotta get the train to come. Come on.
You're weak.
Usually there's certain phases where the game thinks like, okay, you're at half health, you're pretty much screwed, so it plays this cinematic and all that. But by doing the train triggers, we skip all that. The problem is the train isn't coming. So I'm gonna have to try one more strat. There we go. Now it should be coming. There it is. Ah, I missed it! What I'm trying to do is a focused throw. Okay. Please, train. There we go.
Stay behind the white line.
Wow!
This is futile.
That should get it. Nice! Okay, thank you, Thursday, for that strat. Otherwise, you have to beat up Smith and make sure he stays there while the train comes, and that's risky because you can take your own life during that. So, the great streamer Thursday came up with that strat, so I appreciate it. Rustbus, Waza, and Thursday contributed mass things to this game, so I appreciate their presence. Because the Smith fight is very annoying. My first ever PB in this game, I think I spent like 40 minutes on the first Smith fight. It was crazy. And this is the point where the game is going to kind of detract from the normal movie and kind of add their own things. So we're not going to go to the chase right away. Aerial strike number 2 is the one I'm trying to avoid, so remember that. And now we're kind of in this weird other dimension that's apparently part of the old network of the Matrix, a very ancient code, allegedly. Which is kind of cool, because, you know, you just can't go by the movie all the time.
Token.
And we have to make sure that you request a token.
No token. Go get a token in the station. I'll wait.
Game. There we go.
Got it.
And we're gonna collect a token that looks like yen. Because otherwise we can't get on the train. And the tracks are electrified, so.
Plenty of room in the back. All aboard.
Do you have a phone in here?
No phone here.
And we have to ask if he has a phone, otherwise we can't go into the next car. Remember when I said wall running was stupid?
What the hell?
This actually has a slight use here. Otherwise, you have to double jump. Usually when you try to do this, it does this. So what we're actually going to do is come back here, and we're going to hold our focus button, and it's going to allow us to get to the train, phone. And then we're going to call an Uber.
Get me the hell out of here.
Neil!
Again.
There we go. That's totally how it happens in the movie. So now what we're gonna have to do is keep re-entering this car, because every time we re-enter the car rotates, and we need to be right side up. You don't actually have to be right at the door, as long as you get your prompt, whether it be L2, black, or tab. Oh, no! Oh my god, I did it one too many times. Okay. So I had it there, but I screwed up. So now we have to do more cycles. Game? Okay. Okay, alright. At least this won't be world record or PB pace anymore. Okay, now we're right side up. And now we just wait for the announcement, which is why we have subtitles on. If you stop anywhere else, it just shows like a random brick wall or something. Stairs. There we go. There's gonna be evil dudes here. And now we're gonna be at one of the silliest things ever. So this is another impossible thing that happens, that you're supposed to realize that it's impossible, which it is. However, one of the cool parts about this is that Smith is at the top of the stairs, and he doesn't do anything unless you agitate him. And as soon as you agitate him, he'll chase you, and what you can actually do is throw him into the train, and you can kill him. And he won't reappear or anything. However, this is a timed event, so we're waiting on our objective to update. What the game does, though, to adjust populations, because more guys keep coming in, they're going to be coming in up the stairs right there at the top where Agent Smith is. You can probably barely see him. What the game is going to do is slowly reduce their health. So when you sit here, you'll hear groaning and sounds of pain, and they'll actually end up killing themselves because their health is being reduced to control population. It's one of the weirdest things. This is going to take about 2.5 to 3 minutes. So if you want, you can check on donations or remind people about incentives. And the music is very loud, so I apologize. And their one already died. And there they are coming in at the top. And they just get replaced and they die again. It's the weirdest thing. Maybe perhaps this was too difficult in playtesting. There we go. Objectives updated. So now we're going to go over here. And we're going to jump right here. That's all you have to do. Best level ever.
All right, we're heading in. Move, move.
And now we're out of there. Now we're back on the movie. And you get to hear one of the best music tracks in the game. So crank it up. Oops, can I? Yeah, I guess I can take that one. Yeah, I have to take the one outside. That sucks. Because this is just heal others. It's one of the Atman principles. This is a very good music track, I promise.
You've got to move, Neo!
You'll never make it.
Can't escape us.
There must be a way out of here.
You can't run forever, Anderson.
Oh, my bad. I'm trying to skip those rolling animations if I can. They're very slow.
Third floor, room 303.
Oh, I missed it. Yeah, I missed. Oh, nope, I got it. Nice. It's a very difficult trick, but I got it. Gonna do step up side kicks for the most part here because they're very fast. There are mandatory transformations here, so you can't just focus one guy down and kill him. They have to go through certain phases, and they keep blowing through all these walls, so I need to find the other guy real quick. There we go. I actually don't remember the other two guys' names. I think one of them is like Jacobs and something else, I can't remember. The other two Asian names I've been just drawing a blank on. Nice focus, idiot. Oh god, I didn't know I was stunned. Another step up sidekick. Boom. Smith dead. Okay, he had a civilian instead of the cop, that's interesting. I didn't get the Alabama Slammer. I haven't spawned this dude at all. He must be all the way down here. Yeah, there he is. So even though I should have just let him live right there, because I have to do it again. Actually, no, I don't. Okay, it's only Smith I have to do that to. Now here comes the very final bite of Smith. And that is the end of the first movie. I would let the cutscene play, but for some weird reason, Rage Against the Machine's Wake Up is not the song. They replaced the song. I want to upgrade our killing blow real quick. Okay, so here's the difference. I've been getting asked this the entire run. What is the difference? This is the difference right here. Normally all these are going to be red, now they're all green. So if we finish one of these, we move on. So I'm actually going to do... I'll do the key, actually. And this is a replay, so as soon as I finish this, I'll move on to the captain's meeting. That's the big difference. Normally, even during a replay of this, you're going to come out and you're going to have to do the next one as well. Or you have to go back through the menu and go to the next level. That's the big difference. That's why I prefer this version. Because Captain Roland is one of the worst missions. The first one doesn't really have too many issues, which is called the Red Pill Rescue. The healer is actually a really cool character.
Let's get out of here.
This one actually isn't too bad. This is just mostly fighting. The problem with doing the skull is that the grenade can potentially kill me and I have to redo some parts of the game, or the level rather. Even if you take out the main brute first, you have to deal with the other enemies, so... May as well just keep them alive and keep doing combos.
You totally kicked his ass!
Oh, I missed it. Come here.
For that, you
I need to borrow your face. Now the dress is an epic trench coat. And now we get to do a little bit shooty. Another banger of a soundtrack.
Grab
I need a strip. Thank you. You. I need a gun. Thank you. I'm not sure why these guys growl. Maybe they're furries. I'm not sure. Is that a normal thing furries do? Do you growl at each other when you greet one another? Can you stop? Or maybe they just don't have fingernail clippers. They're actually going to reuse that exact same texture modeling later. And instead, there's going to be people hiding inside the pillars. So anyway, that's the Red Pillar Rescue. The revive is mostly useless because once you have a fallen ally, you usually lose. So it's useless to have that. Okay, so now we're prepping for the captain's meeting. And we have upgraded agents who can regenerate health. And most notably, Smith is absent because he's no longer taking orders. But don't worry, we're gonna check on Smith here in a few minutes. Yep, exactly. Upgrades. And we're gonna be introduced to Code Vision. Sound is bugged a little bit. Oh, really? That guy's a little bit annoying up there. And that's it.
What the hell is going on?
And now we're going to go to Captain's meeting, meaning that we're actually going to go rescue Morpheus and Trinity. And once again, everything's lit up, so we have a choice between all of these. And we are not doing Captain Roland because he deserves to be let to die, if I can spell correctly or word correctly sentences. Conjunction, junction, what's your function? And Morpheus and Trinity is basically shooty fast, so that makes it very fast. Here's one of the stupidest features of the game. You actually don't jump down there. If you jump down there, you die and you fail. You have to jump and then wait for the cutscene. It's one of the dumbest things I've ever seen in the game.
Neo, they hit the car with the grenade. We've been pinned down.
This guy has a grenade launcher, and I kind of want it. Holy cow. See, look how great that riot shield is. There we go. Yep. Sentences and stuff. Verbs and pronouns.
Got company.
Neo, there are more SWAT teams en route. We have to move quickly.
And there's an NVIDIA sign right there on the wall. I'm not sure if you can see that, but shameless advertising. And if you notice I'm putting away my weapon and drawing it out again, that's faster target selection than using the right stick. Landed in the fire, that's pretty great. That was the grab I was talking about. When we're on the rooftops rescuing rescuing Morpheus, I talked about that, and that's what it looks like. Oh god. I'm getting bonked. Oh. Taking a long time because I got bonked around. There's less frames down here. As soon as I get done with this, they'll give me next checkpoint. And I don't remember if I have the grenade launcher, do I? I do. Good. One of the greatest voice lines of all time right here.
Neo, the grenade launcher, now.
And watch this helicopter. Just comes swinging in. Come on, stand still. There you go. Beautiful. Easy. It's like they dropped it in from a tightrope or something like that, you know?
We can take it from here. Make sure.
Yeah, we'll make sure everyone else gets out. Not. So there's your big thing right there. That's the reason I'm on PS2. I'll take the loading screens and all the other stuff, just to skip all that stuff. And now here comes Seraph. And he has an apology. And somehow his glasses are not ever broken. Maybe it's just because they're true John Lennons, but you never know. Then again, my glasses never get broken either. It's probably one of the weirdest fights in the game. We're in a weird spot right now. I want to keep him over here. Come on. It's been a marathon fight, truly. That was really lucky right there. I shouldn't have gotten that. Holy cow, that ending though was worth it. And now here's what I call the Dark Side Phil section of the fight. For the big time combo here, because it's better just to do the standard grab. Uh-oh, I broke my weapon. And now we're gonna go back and fight in the same place again. If you notice, I'm not using my aerial attack very much because it tends to be kind of buggy in this fight. The aerial focus attack, the hyper strike. Especially going from table to flat surface, things kind of get messy. And the reason for Sarah's apology is you never truly know someone until you fight them. And now he knows that Neo is the one. And Neo's response is, you could have just asked. And now time for the Burly Brawl. one of the more fun levels of the game. A good warm-up level if you are a speedrunner. And we're just trying to kill people and cause violence, because the more chaos we cause, the more this progresses. Like that. And we want to keep doing that. Eventually the game tells you that you have to use this, so you can just pick it up early.
Mr. Anderson?
And here's phase three. And now we want to throw people at buildings. And I'm going to turn on my coat vision. He is hyper striking. You can either do this in a conventional combo, or you can do it in a focus combo, where he basically skewers people just like that. There he goes! And there goes another one! Do you ever just hate somebody enough that you just want to throw them into a building?
Mr. Anderson.
That was bugged. And especially with code vision, you can see when a smith comes out of the crowd and actually exists. And now the buildings are falling down.
You think one mere building can stop all of us?
You can't stop. I need to go get another weapon. It's over here. Problem with traversing like this is a new smith can randomly come out just like that. So I like to have code vision on quite a bit, like I mentioned. That's weird, he did not hit the building. Yeah, surprisingly, the PS2 is actually keeping up pretty well with how many enemies are on screen right now. This level has been done in 1 minute and 2 seconds, believe it or not. I believe the secret in this level is defeating 50 smith enemies or something. Missed my flip. That's all right. Missed another one. Nice. I'm out of ammo. Where's my... I can't see any. Oh, here's one. I missed another one. There we go. Okay, the game recognized that they kind of screwed me. Yeah, some of it's from the movie, some of it is not. I'm in a bad spot right now. Oop, there we go. And that's it. That was a very slow, burly brawl, but I don't care. That level's fun. Alright, another fun level. Yeah. What in the world? Okay, I didn't even see what happened. I sure have a lot of expensive stuff for us to break in here. He got some serious distance. Actually did a really good job on, what's his name's model? What's his name? I always forget his name. Over here. It's gonna come to me at a random point. It's not Romani, is it? We don't have to defeat any of these guys, really. Oh, I still have my weapon. I didn't even know I still had it. Just gonna scream and kill everybody. Hate that.
Ah, here we are. As I said,
So, for those of you who played this, if you manage to make it this far, this is the point of the game where you probably quit. Because this part is very stupid coming up here. Grand game. I spent so long in this as a 12 or 13 year old kid. I just couldn't figure it out.
Behind these doors, you will find the path to your friends. Each door brings you a little closer to your lover. But there are hounds lurking in the halls. Vile things, mists, and nightmares. Now run along, boy. Make your choice.
Thing is, you don't really have a choice. You just go with the first one. And I'm not quite sure where or how they got the idea for the giant ants, but they're kind of creepy. This is always the same every time, by the way. Yeah, I mean, here's a random ant for some reason. There we go. Please stop. I'm gonna take a safe way up here. Yeah, this area casually just takes a long time.
Perfect timing. I could use a little help here.
I have to wait on that dialogue because if I move it too soon,
finally.
I didn't even move it, but okay.
Let me see if I can open the gate from my side.
So here's what we're gonna do. If I can get up here. Oh my, please? I don't want this. Oh, God. Oh, oh God. Okay, that dude is just chilling over there. This is another wait area that you just have to wait on her to go get the objective. So, if you want to do any donation shenanigans, now would be your time. I just gotta wait on her to open this door.
Yeah, just a quick reminder that there's a lot of upcoming bid wars, such as the car body and car color for Road Trip Adventure. You can snag that car color with just $1, and that will be coming up right after Sega Rally Championship. So if you have a favorite color, it'd be an easy way to snag it there. Save or kill the animals. The animals are still winning, so they're being saved. So if you dislike animals, you better donate a good $15. That will get you those nice killed animals.
It's natural selection. You just gotta kill the animals. That's the way Space Rangers intended.
As a racer in that race, I actually like saving the animals, so maybe you could even donate towards saving the animals more.
Okay. Alright, she opened it up, so we're good to go. Perfect timing.
Good luck, Valerie.
Alright, thank you. So there's a little shortcut you're supposed to take and all that, but it goes bad like that really quickly because I have like 3 frames here. So I'm actually gonna go up here and just jump across. Zoop. Oh god. There we go. Okay, I thought I failed for a second. I was like, wait a minute. But my brain is just tired. Okay. Well, where am I now? Okay. Don't die. Okay, we're almost out of here. As soon as we reach this door at the end, then we're out of the chateau. Or chateau's maze. Yeah, I'll take anyone on in the bracket. Don't apologize for that. I'll take on anyone. So anyway, by any means, if this does go into another marathon anywhere, the next time you see it, but most likely will be on PC. Barring some kind of miracle that makes a certain version faster again. These enemies are very strange. They have like weird mystical powers. I'm not sure what they are.
Don't let him get past you or I'll have your head.
Why do you stand on the pod? I need lots of ammunition. Because there's a certain boss coming up here that absolutely just has a lot of HP, gun-wise. Nah, I dodged that. Do I have something better? I do, okay. I don't want to use it yet. I want to use everything else. camera just not liking me today. And then they reset you at the beginning and make you do everything all over again, but just to a harder degree. And I gotta make sure all these guys spawn. Is that everybody? No. Actually, yeah, that is everybody. The problem with this strat is, if you run out of focus, you're dead. Oh, there is another one. A problem. No. I need this health back. Yes. Where are my guns? I have smoke grenades, okay. Oh, those are real grenades. Won't stop coming. They're finally done now. Oh. Doesn't matter if I collect the secret, it's just fun. I gotta defeat all these guys before that door unlocks. I just want to spawn them. Okay, nice wall run on an invisible wall. Can you please die? Thank you. I don't want to use my ammo, but this is just ridiculous. Okay, it didn't give me ammo that I picked up. Nice. That might be a problem. Okay, I didn't even kick him, and it kicked him. That's awesome. Okay, I want to make sure I get this. Do I have any yeah. Nice. Okay, I was like, can I have your weapon? Okay, here we go. This witch lady is very crazy, and if I ever do the one difficulty like I want to do, I'm very scared of this fight, because she's easy with guns, but, or witch man lady thingy, I don't know. Okay, we're very close to the end of the game now. This is the final encounter with the Chateau. And then we go into Revolutions. So, Reload is almost over. This is the biggest skip in the game that's possible in all versions, but it's very difficult to do on console for some reason. I'm gonna go for it anyway, but I most likely will not get it. The correct one is actually on the left here.
Neo, it's me!
But we're actually gonna do this one, because if we do this one and get it wrong, she only has partial health. As you can see on the left. Got the wrong one. That's fine. That's fine. Whatever. I don't really care about going for it. The problem is that she has 4,500 health, and that's higher than any enemy in the game. We're just agitating her right now, because a certain amount of her health has to go down, and then she respawns again in an actual fist-to-fist fight with a staff. However, due to splat physics in a corner right there at the beginning, if you get her trapped there, her health will actually go down so fast that it skips the next phase. However, I cannot do it on this version just yet. I'm not saying it's impossible, but it's very difficult. Normally you're supposed to, you know, try to dodge all the things she throws, but it's so inconsistent from a gameplay perspective, just in basic, not just doing a speedrun style. It hardly ever hits, and it's a big pain, so it's better just to bum rush her. Even though she disappears quite a bit, if you don't get the stun, but still. Usually, about 40%, I believe, is when she goes into the next phase, so we should be pretty close. But the problem is, she gets a health refill if you don't get the trick. But at least she doesn't do the stupid disappearing act again. However, with evolution, she gets a new ability, which is a hyper strike. There it is. Now she has extra health and she has a staff. We're gonna take that staff from her because she doesn't need it. And there's the hyper strike. We're gonna take care of that though. Bonk. Oh god. Her hyperstrike has insane range as well. Her hyperstrike, if it lands properly, it'll take 3/4 of her health. No, God, oh, God, no. Okay. Okay, I thought she was gonna land it. That might have killed me. I'd say my hypersect's faster than yours. She was building up too. She cheated. She literally cheated. She used her teleport right when I was about to hyperstrike. That's awesome. Oh God. Gotcha. Okay, she has a lot of health, as you can see. So, if you get that trick that saves several minutes, many minutes, maybe 6 to 7 minutes. Okay, now we're officially done with Reloaded. Revolutions begins. What happened to my focus aerial throw? Am I crazy? Or am I bugged? Alright. Now is a level called Tuned Out, which introduces the Keymaker. Most of these levels are just time-based.
Quickly, we must save him before it's too late.
So nice of you to join.
My frames are quite bad here, so I'm gonna be doing a lot of code vision.
Neo, above you!
And these agents aren't near as tough as normal agents. They're just Smith clones. They're very weak. Very weak, as I say, because of my ass kicked by them. Oh god! Jesus Christ, I'm getting killed by this guy. This is a weak one, too. Okay.
I see two of me got a little over-ambitious. No matter, there's plenty more of me where that came from.
Stay away!
Neo, you take the right branch. I'll take the left branch.
That's suicide.
Neo, what happens to me does not matter. All that matters, at this point, is saving the Keymaker.
Split up, that's always the best option.
As you will soon see, I've grown much stronger since last we met.
Ow! My controller is bugged and it won't stop vibrating. This is very strange. Okay, there it goes. Yeah, these agents have, like, next to no HP. I wasn't exaggerating. Actually, I'm an idiot. I thought this was closer.
This way, Mr. Anderson. Over here, Mr. Anderson. There, I see you, Mr. Anderson. You can't escape me.
Very creepy. And now we have to save the Keymaker. Because Smith's plan is to get rid of the Keymaker so that way no one can escape. However, sometimes the Keymaker can get stuck, so we have to go back for him. In theory, we could just leave him here and try to get to a checkpoint. The problem is he has to come to the dead end that we're about to get to. He makes some very good gargle noises. And he just does this weird T-pose thing. Kind of crazy. Really use a weapon in this area for crowd control, but the game doesn't give it to me. It only gives me this, which kind of works. Hands off my lover. Ow!
Let me at him.
That's a little excessive. That Smith is just not worried about me at all.
One thing we've learned is, if one is not enough, then keep adding more, and more, and more.
You're very mean. Boom! Pele kick.
Just hurry!
You will fail, Mr. Anderson. It is inevitable.
Ow! Let me kick you. Thank you. No! You bitch. Yeah. Throw you into freaking oblivion. Into the pit. Okay, here's the dead end. Hopefully the Keymaker's still alive. There he is.
It's a dead end.
Neo! Get them off of me!
And now they just throw us into this weird dimension door that we don't know what it is. So now the Keymaker has to make a new key to find a way out. Or a proper exit, rather. And we end up in this church. Just in time. For the most part, this is just going to be an auto-scroller. The problem is we have to make sure Morpheus stays alive. If Morpheus dies, the level's over. And Morpheus still hasn't learned anything because he's still trying to shoot agents. Good news is our frame rate is much better here.
I hope the Keymaker had a plan to get us.
Could be a sequence of him opening a door, then saying it's not safe, yada yada yada. I need to go upstairs. No! There we go. However, there is one cutscene I'm going to let you watch. And that is the next one. In the Ministry. Hey, thanks, he threw me into it. I'm gonna go downstairs next. Hey, thanks. Also drops magical little gifts like focus, ammunition, or health. Well, rip, there goes the organ. I didn't even know we can actually break that. That's kind of cool. Now we're gonna go back upstairs. Please stop hitting me. That was a sick jump.
The door!
Ow! So if you remember during this time frame, San Andreas had not quite come out.
There's your answer, Neo.
And a certain name of Jack Thompson was very prevalent.
And I firmly believe that these awful, horrible, violent video games are offensive to our most basic values. What the hell are you boys doing?
We don't have time for this.
We have to make it.
Okay, anyway. Yeah, they say these violent, horrible, evil video games.
You can't fight all of us, Mr. Anderson.
Keep moving, they're everywhere.
Hurry up with that door!
Without these violent, horrible, evil video games, we wouldn't be able to raise money for charity. Oh god, Morpheus is dying. There's nothing really to do in this level except make sure Morpheus doesn't die and the Keymaker doesn't get hit. Because if the Keymaker gets hit, he cowers and stops doing his little thing over there. So I got to keep an eye on him. And the fun part is you can still throw people into the wall because there's the Burly Brawl physics in here. Yep, you can still flip them just like that. And now we get grenade launchers.
Get to the Keymaker, I'll cover you.
Cause the only thing worse than an agent is an agent with a machine gun. Okay. Okay. We are almost there. Now we have a very long, unskippable in-game cutscene instead of this being a movie clip, and I don't know why. My only guess is that they didn't have room for the movie clip, maybe? So you can't actually skip this. If I could ask, what is my current time? Because I don't have my timer on.
I wish you could see yourself, Mr. Anderson. Helpless. Pathetic.
That's not too bad of a time. Not world record or anything, but not too bad considering it's a marathon.
You can't stop me.
It's not going to PB, but it's going to be at least under 3 hours. Oh!
Alright. Sorry about that.
No, you're fine.
If you got a 236.09, yeah, since this one pretty under, if you've got like a quick bonus to show, that'd be pretty good.
I want to show another one of the cutscenes, if I can.
Okay. Yeah, go for it.
All right.
Yeah.
It keeps giving me the wrong combo. That's kind of annoying. There we go. The game is just acting weird right now. This is just a series of fights against Smith, like throwing him from this range and blowing stuff up. It's the epic final showdown. And here comes my most hated part of the game. And my strat is very stupid for this, because my strat is literally just to charge at him and hope for the best. Because there's certain fights that it's gonna initiate that's gonna make this really long and tedious. My very first PB had a ridiculous fight here. And part of it was getting that to do this, where he's on like this weird jackety thing. Cause you have to do this fight. You can't skip any of the fights. That'd be cool if you could, but you have to skip this. Well, you have to fight this rather, if I can speak. And the problem is, if you get struck very strong here, you have to do another fight below this floor, which is stupid. Anyway, if you fail this, the late game is very punishing. Because if you fail this, you lose so much time to extra fights. And I've lost many a run to this area. Okay, did the range one again. Nice. Okay, good. Now we're back outside. Just in case the audience is wondering, my PB is 2 hours, 44 minutes, and 26 seconds. Which I'm not going to get, unfortunately. If I get good luck here, he's not going to charge me at all. Because if we both charge, nothing happens. Oh, that's not nice. That's not very nice. And if you notice, I'm getting focus back on hit, so I can just infinitely do this as long as it's connecting. He can dodge this, though. Like that. Now I need him to hit me. There we go. That's fine. I'll take that. Just as long as we don't have another fight. If he gets a good hit on me and initiates the fight, then I have to do it. He can throw me against a building, which is fine. I just don't want to start another inside fight. There we go. This is what I like to see. Alright, now another street fight. Actually want to see if it'll play this. Okay, we gotta wait.
My power has grown as well, Mr. Anderson.
Oh, okay. I was out of range.
My world!
The face is amazing. It looks just as bad on PC, don't worry. I did that intentionally. You can usually skip that, but it's so funny. So we're going to skip the Wachowski sisters talking, and this is a cutscene they made by themselves. This isn't from the movie. It's a really cool cutscene with the alternate ending. That's the best part when he grabs the sunglasses. So we're gonna want to make sure we're behind these barriers right here. Because if he hits them, he's gonna taunt. And when he taunts, we can just do this. I don't know why I'm holding focus. That just takes up time. So we want to make sure we can get to the rubble. Wow. Really? There we go. The problem is there's a big time hitch after you do an evasion. So that's where it gets dangerous. For some reason in this phase, he throws agents in the air, and I don't know why. It's kind of weird. It's like a discharge, I guess. There's another phase that I hopefully don't see where you're on the ground, dodging cars. If you get hit enough, he'll just throw you. And then the music will randomly stop sometimes. And if we have a cycle long enough like that, he'll just do the taunt himself.
Just let me know when you're ready to transition over after this, if you have anything more to show over. Yep.
His arm still has to fall off first. Oh, really? Now the arm has fallen off. We're getting very close now. I will let you know when it's time. And time.
Alright, GG.
Did I get under 3 hours at least?
He did it!
What happened? There was an error with the timer, but
okay.
Yeah. You did good though.
Yeah, it wasn't. I just want to get under 3 hours. That's fine.
Yeah, do you have anything else to say or any shoutouts?
Main thing is I want more people to get this because there's so much unknown that we don't know about this, like version differences and all kinds of stuff. If we can find a way to get it that we could do the escort mission skips on PC would be faster by like 10 million miles. That's what I'm trying to get people to do right now. If they have Xbox version, PS2 version, get any version of PC that you can, even if it's cracked, it doesn't matter. Just find a way to get it and experiment and try to find some new cool stuff. And there is a Discord, it's kind of discombobulated, but does exist out there. If you go to the speedrun page for this, I'm the moderator for it. Submit ILs, anything. Just get the ball rolling, and this should be a pretty awesome speed game in no time. I'd like to thank Thursday, Waza, and Rustbus. Yeah, copyright claim right here, yeah.
All right. Well, thank you for the run, Valerie.
Yep, no problem.
Up next. Yeah.
Yep. Racing Block is up next.
Yes. Racing Block is going to be awesome. We have got Sega Rally Championship with the BPG. So stick around for that.
I've heard that Road... Is it called Road Adventure? What is after Sega Rally?
The Road Trip Adventure.
Oh, okay. I've heard that's a good...